back, please. Front of the back. Thank you.
Take that mask off real quick, Teal.
No? Okay. I'm on a antibiotic.
I hear you.
Did you see his last knockout? His last knockout? First round, Sammy Vargas.
I don't mean like, it's not like, you know, but I'm sure he, nah, I've seen his work though. He's good, man. He's nice.
Appreciate
with
that, bro.
Thank you. Hey, you want to sit down?
Go ahead, guys.
Tio, media day. Look how many cameras are here for you today.
I know, man. What a change, right? It's crazy. I appreciate all you guys being here today, man. Thank you, first and foremost, man. Obviously, I got to keep the mask on. You know, I've been under some medication and stuff that lowers my immune system at the moment. So, you just got to be careful with COVID and all that. But I just say, man, I thank all of y'all, first and foremost. Like I said before, y'all don't understand how much this means to me and to my team. To see the process and how much we progressed throughout our years. 19 years in already. And, man, this is just a warm-up. This is just the beginning.
Tio, you know, with George talking about how hungry he is and the way he's coming into this fight, is that something you can take advantage of, the way he's approaching this fight, trying, you know, talk about making it a war and all of those things?
I mean, that's what he got to say, you know. At the end of it all, George Kambosos has got to go out there and do his part, you know, just like I had to do with Loma and everything. So at the end of it all, I'm always gonna, I need guys like him, and I need guys like in my division to keep me on my toes at all times. You know, I don't overlook nobody. I stay focused on everybody at one at a time. And eventually we'll line everybody up where we don't have to use my whole clip. We just use one bullet and just a straight shooter, one shot.
I asked Josh Taylor about fighting you. What do you think about you and Josh Taylor? He has all the belts at 140.
Fuck, I've been talking about it. Let's make it happen, yo. He's talking about moving up to 147, which I figured, yo. They scared, man. They all scared. That's how I look at it, man. They know, man. I'm too fast. I'm too smart. I'm too sharp. And I'm too strong. You know, he'd rather go up at 147 because he'll be the lighter guy. He'll be quicker on his feet. And he'll be able to handle himself more at 147. I ain't stupid, man. I see how the game go. But eventually, they're going to have to feel that pressure. And I'm going to come at them, too. Just like we asked about it with Loma.
Tio, you know, with Josh, like you mentioned, he's light on his feet. And, you know, if you fought a Josh Taylor, would you have to be the aggressor in that fight to cut distance? You know, he's a tall guy, likes to move around.
Like the most technical fighter, and I outboxed him. What the hell does Josh Taylor bring to the table? Just he bring my belts. That's all he does.
Well, you know, Loma was a guy who came forward, and Josh is more. So
Josh came forward too. I'm sure he did. He did the clinches. They did all the other stuff they had to do. Yo, at the end of it, man, y'all don't smell it, but I do. And I smell fear in all those guys. I can see it in their face, and I can see it in their team. They feel that pressure. I'm young, but at the same time, I'm ready, man. I told y'all though, it's too late for all of them now. It's too late. The fact that I faced Lomachenko, I like to challenge myself first and foremost, and that just elevated me to a whole nother level now. June 19th, when it comes, y'all gonna really see it. Really gonna see it. I see everything. I see it more clearly now than I did before, and I appreciate